Hola, hola, buenos días. Hola, Ricardo Gamero, buenos días. ¿Cómo está? Okay, hola Mía, buenos días. Santiago, buenos días. Excelente, me parece muy bien. Okay, llegamos al día martes y ya casi finalizamos nuestro mes de junio. Sí, solo nos queda el día de hoy y mañana. Ya día jueves comenzamos el nuevo mes, que es el mes de julio, y es el último mes para cerrar el periodo 2. Okay, ya casi terminamos el periodo 2. Imagínense, llevamos a mitad de año. Ya solo nos quedaría un periodo para finalizar el año escolar. Increíble. Ha pasado súper rápido el tiempo. Bueno, gracias a Dios porque ha sido muy bueno con cada uno de nosotros. Hemos llegado hasta acá y no dudamos que vamos a seguir, que nos vamos a seguir esforzando. Ok, excelente chicos. Muy bien, bienvenidos. Esta va a ser nuestra clase de repaso de EFL y luego a las 9 de la mañana es el horario sugerido que le hemos dado para que usted desarrolle su evaluación. ¿De acuerdo? Ok, perfecto. Antes que nada vamos a orar. Nos vamos a encomendar al Señor esta mañana para que Él nos ayude, Él nos ilumine en las evaluaciones que tengamos el día de ahora y sobre todo le vamos a pedir sabiduría y entendimiento para poder finalizar este periodo 2 de la mejor manera, siendo responsables con cada una de nuestras actividades. Hola, buenos días. Ok, bienvenido. Muy bien, oramos chicos. Ok, gracias amado Padre por esta mañana en la cual tú nos has permitido, Señor, estar acá. Agradecemos, Señor, por cada una de las maravillas que tú nos regalas. Agradecemos, Señor, porque tenemos un techo, Señor, tenemos alimento, tenemos vestuario, recibimos educación. Te pedimos, Señor, de manera especial por las personas que no poseen cada una de estas bendiciones, Señor, que seas tú quien se las provea. Pedimos de manera especial por los que están enfermos para que seas tú quien le dé la pronta sanidad. Sabemos que tú eres el mejor médico de todos y no dudamos de que tú vas a hacer tu obra en ellos. Además, Señor, te pedimos por las personas que viven en zonas de riesgo. Sabemos que estamos entrando a la etapa del invierno. Te pedimos que tú les des el discernimiento necesario para poder tomar medidas que sean adecuadas para su vida. Te pedimos de manera especial por nuestras evaluaciones, Señor, para que nosotros podamos poner todo nuestro empeño en ella, para que podamos demostrar todo lo que hemos aprendido y sobre todo para que nosotros podamos contestar de la mejor manera, llenos de sabiduría. Agradecemos, Señor, porque estamos ya casi en la recta final del periodo 2 y hasta aquí tú nos has ayudado. Tú has sido muy bueno con nosotros. Ayúdanos a seguir siendo responsables con cada una de nuestras actividades, Señor, y a dar lo mejor de nosotros mismos. En el nombre del Señor. Amén. Ok, so let's see, let's start. Good morning. Welcome to your EFL class. This one is a review class. Yes, ok, let's start with this one. I evaluate in the test, ok, vocabulary of unit number 4 and vocabulary of unit number 5. Yeah, in that case, number 4 is about party. Yes. Okay, so let's check some vocabulary in that part and then we practice, yeah, with the game. So we have here in the balloons, we have cup. You know that this one is a container that we use for, let me see, spill some juice, okay, soda, etc. Invitation, you know that this one is a card that you give to other person, okay, that joined to your celebration. Then we have the plate, okay, the plate is, let me see, is something that you use for serve the cake. Then we have the napkin, this one is an object that you use for cleaning your mouth, okay, snacks. Okay, we can say that we have different snacks, yes, potato, chips, let me see, what else? Churritos, Diana, yeah, all of these kind of snacks, nuts, yes. We have decorations, we can include balloons, let me see, a banner, etc. We have the fork, that is the let me see, the supply that we use for cutting the cake, yeah. Then we have the spoon and the knife. This one is part of the vocabulary, yes. So let's repeat, invitation, cup, plate, napkin, snacks, decorations, fork, a spoon, and knife. These one are parts of the supplies that you use in a party, yeah, but we have others. For example, okay, we use a birthday hat, yeah, some bows, a birthday card, okay, in a gift tag, okay, you use this one in a, let me see, in a bag, yeah, in a birthday bag. Then we have some gift, candies, okay, we have some cookies, chocolates, okay, the cake, okay, we can have an ice cream bar, yeah, or maybe candy bar, etc. Okay, popcorn, ice cream, confetti, decorations, etc. Okay, so all of this one are part of the vocabulary. But also we have some expressions, yes, that we use. For example, prepare the snacks. Okay, when you say prepare the snacks, that's mean you put in a container, could be in a bowl, okay, different snacks. For example, pretzel, I told you churritos Diana, yes. Tocino, I don't know if you like this kind of a snack. ¿Le gustan esas boquitas, las boquitas Diana? Yes or no? Okay, what is your favorite snack in that case? We have a lot of, yeah?
You got chino.
Ah, my is chino. Yeah, this one is delicious. Okay, what else? Muelitas. Yes, this is another one. Okay.
Chitos.
Ah, okay. We have maíz japonés. Yes. Maní japonés, yeah. Maní con chile. Okay. Tell me, Carlos.
Yo o el otro Carlos.
You. I'm sorry, Carlos Arias.
El snack favorito es los churros.
Okay. Churritos. Okay, that's good. We have platanitos, yeah? Okay, all of these are snacks. So that's mean when you put all of these kind of snacks in a bowl, that's mean you prepare the snacks. Okay, you pour the drinks. That's mean when you serve, yeah, in a cup. You serve the orange juice, you serve, let me see, the soda. Ah, you say gomitas. Yeah, this one is delicious, gomitas. Exactly. Okay. Bake the cake. Okay, that's when you prepare all the ingredients. Okay, or maybe your mom prepares all the ingredients. Okay, then put all the ingredients in a container and she bakes the cake. Pick out the music. Okay, that's mean you prepare the music for the celebration. Yeah. Happy birthday to you, okay? And if you have a, let me see, a kid party, okay? You have a lot of songs, yes? Okay, put up the decoration. That's mean you put all the things in the correct place. Inflate the balloon, okay? Get the games ready and send the invitations. All of these are expressions. So let's repeat. Prepare the snacks, pour the drinks, bake the cake, pick out the music, put up the decorations, inflate the balloons, get the games ready, and send the invitations. Okay, so let's see. Now we play, okay, with this part of the vocabulary. So we play, let me check this part. Yeah, this one is the birthday vocabulary. So you need to choose a letter. You tell me what is the letter that you choose. Yeah, and let me check. We try to complete the word. Okay, let's see. Let's start. Carlos Arias, give me one letter.
Sí.
Sí. Okay, let's see. No. Okay, Ricardo Romero, give me one letter.
F.
S. Okay, let's see. No. Anderson, give me one letter.
A.
A, okay, let's check. Yes, A. We have 36 seconds. Yes, okay, Fabiola Enriquez, give me one letter. Okay, Fabi. Okay, give me one letter. Okay, Diego Lopez, give me one letter.
P.
P, okay, let's see. No, Mia Rivera, give me one letter. Okay, how the hell right now? Okay.
B.
B, okay. The second one or this one? B in vowel or B in bold? The second one. Okay, so let's see. Yes. So let's see. Santiago, give me one letter. And if you know the word, you tell me. Okay, so this one is part of the accessory.
N.
N, okay, let me see. Yes, we have an N, that's good. Adriana.
N.
L, what is the word?
Sí.
Okay, this one is?
Balloons.
Balloons, yeah, exactly, okay. This one is the word, balloon. Okay, next one. Let's see. Gerard, give me one letter. Okay, hurry up, Gerard, because we have time, yeah? Okay, Carlos Cornejo, give me one letter.
Okay, L.
L, okay, let me check. Yes, it's this one. Let's see, Fernando Bermudez, give me one letter. Okay, Marian Navas, give me one letter.
E.
Okay, E, let's check. Yes, okay. Let's see. Daniela Marin, give me one letter. Oh my God. Okay, Daniela Borja, give me one letter. Okay, hurry up. Marcus, give me one letter.
A.
A, okay, let's see, yes. What is the word, do you know? What is this one? Okay, so let's see, another one. So you activate your sound and you give me one letter, yes?
B.
B. Okay, the second one, be in boat or be in bed?
Be in boat.
Be in boat. Okay, yes. Let me check. Do you know what is this one? No? Okay. Me? Let's see. Okay, someone says that it's letter C. Let me check if it is letter C. Yes. No, it's not letter C. Okay, let me see letter F. No. Letter T. Okay. Table, yes. This one's letter T. Okay, next one. Let's see. Give me one letter.
A.
A. Okay, so let's see. A. Let me check. I think I can move this one. Okay, A. Yes. Another one.
C.
C, okay, yes. What else? This one is easy. E, okay, yeah. And it's missing one letter.
It's there.
Okay. So we put some candles on it and we start. Okay, cake, yeah. Yes, it's this one. So we have right now, perfect, yeah. Plus seven, let's see, the last one. Give me one letter.
A.
A, okay, no.
O.
O.
Yes.
Yes, okay, no. S, okay, let's see. S, yes. Mia Rivera says S. Okay, another one. Okay, maybe a vowel. So you have the vowel E, I, and U.
E.
E. Okay, let's check. Yes. Uh-huh. Now a consonant. Give me a consonant in that case. Okay. M, okay, let's check. M, no, it's not M. Okay, let me check N. No, it's not N.
C.
C, okay, yes. Aha, uh-huh. What is that word? Okay. Let me check letter R. No, it's not letter R. Letter L. No, it's not letter L. Oh my God, what do you think is this one?
Letter U?
Okay, and what is that word? This one is, okay, no. Punctuation 16, yes, the time 6 minutes 50 seconds, yeah? Wow, but we are the first one in the table.
It's a new record.
Ay, ay, this one is a new record. Yeah, exactly. Okay, let me check in that case.
¿Cuál era la palabra, mi?
Okay, this one is. Okay, but this show you. Let me check if you can show you. No, it's not possible. Let's see. See? Okay. Maybe at the end of the class, yeah, we discover. Okay? Okay, that's good. Let's continue.
Continuará.
Yeah, to be continued. Okay, that's good. So let's see. This one is part of the vocabulary. And then we have the unit number 5. Yeah? We have nationalities and countries. Yeah? Remember, if we, let me see, we're born in Spain, so we are Spanish, yeah? Mexico, we are Mexican. The United States, American. Japan, Japanese. China, Chinese. Italy, Italian. France, French. In Great Britain, British. Yes, okay, these one are countries in nationality. Country, Spain. So I tell you the country and you tell me the nationality. Yes, okay, Spain, what is the nationality? Okay, what is the nationality?
Spanish.
Spanish, okay, Mexico?
Mexican.
Mexican, okay, the United States?
American.
Okay, Japan?
Japanese.
Okay, China?
Chinese.
Okay, Italy?
Italian.
Okay, France?
French.
Okay, in Great Britain?
Yes, British.
British, okay, British or British, yes. These are some nationalities and some countries, yeah? Okay, and also remember, we have some cooking expressions, that means some verbs that we use when we cook, okay? For example, number one, we say, the Italian chef is baking the pie, okay? In that case, when you, let me see, prepare a cake, when you prepare cookies, okay, bread, etc., you don't say, okay, the Italian chef is cooking the pie. You say baking, hornear, yes, baking the pie. Remember this kind of verbs, yeah, this one, that expression that we use, okay, baking, bake the pie. Next one, okay, the Japanese chef is stirring the soup, okay, so what is that? When you move. Okay, when you move in that form, yeah, this one is stirring, okay? Removiendo, moviendo. Number three, the Spanish chef is boiling the potatoes. What is the meaning of boiling? Hervir, yes, boiling. Number four, the Chinese chef is frying the fish. What is the meaning of frying? Freir, yes? Okay, the French chef is grilling the meat. What is grilling the meat? In that case is, okay, when you prepare a barbecue. Cuando lo hace usted en barbacoa, yes? Okay, asar. Number six, the British chef is peeling the apples. What is the meaning of peeling? Pelar, okay? We're peeling the apples. The Mexican chef is slicing the bread, okay? Está partiendo en rodajas el pan, slicing. And the American chef is chopping the vegetables, okay? Picando, chopping the vegetables. These one are the verbs that we study, okay? Bake, stir, boiling, fry, grill, peel, slice, and chopping or chop, yes? Okay, remember the meaning of this one, yes? Baking, what is the meaning in Spanish? Okay, bake.
Pastel.
Hornear, okay, yes. Okay, bake. Steer, what is the meaning?
Remover.
Okay, remover o mezclar. Yes, boil. What is the meaning of boil? Hervir, yes, okay. Fry, what is the meaning?
Freir.
Okay, grill, what is that? Grill. Asar, yes, okay. Peel, what is the meaning?
Cortar.
Pelar, okay.
Ah, pelar.
Uh-huh. Slice, rebanar. Okay, and chop, picar, yes? Okay, so that's good. This one is part of the vocabulary that we study, yeah? Okay, now we practice countries and nationalities. Yes? Okay, let me share this part with you. Okay, this one, but it's not that, it's that part. Okay, so let's see, let me play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, yeah? Okay, you know that this one is a famous game, yes? Okay, so let's see. A Greek comes from, what is the country? If I'm a Greek person, Great Britain, Germany, Greenland, or Greece? A, B, C, or D? What do you think?
D.
Okay, D. Una persona griega viene de Grecia, ¿verdad? Okay, Greece. Yes, this one is okay. Okay, so let's see, we have this one.
Ganamos la fortuna.
Okay.
Inglaterra.
Okay, so let's see. Hans comes from Germany and he is A, B, C, or D? German, Germanian, Dutch, or Greek?
A.
Okay, so you say A.
Ay, por favor,
in the chat. Okay, Ivania says, okay, listen, Ivania says B, you say A, okay, let me choose. Okay, turn off your microphone, please. Apaguemos micrófono para que podamos escuchar.
Ahora, sigamos con el video.
Okay. Okay, so let's see, you say B. Okay, you say B, yes. Let's see. No, this one is A. Okay, if you come, okay. Okay, let's try it again. Let's start. Okay, let's start with 500, yeah? Okay, a Greek comes from, you choose this one, yeah? D. Okay, one more time. Okay, let's see, 1,000. So that's mean this one is?
A.
A, okay.
Ah! Se movió.
Sí,
que se mueve para callar a uno.
Ah, no,
okay, a grid comes from A, B, C, or D?
Sí.
Okay, so let's see now. 1,000. Okay, let's see. Hans comes from Germany and he is?
Sí.
Sí. Okay. A, sí. B, C, or sí. D? C, okay.
Al fin.
Okay, 5,000. Let's see. This sentence says, okay, Teresa is from Spain and she is?
Spanish.
Okay, D.
Spanish.
Spanish. Okay, so let's see. 5,000. Okay, Roberto comes from Portugal and he is
Portuguese.
Portuguese. Portuguese. Okay. Okay, now 250,000. A Swiss. Swiss is from Sweden, Switzerland, Switzerland, Spain.
Sweden.
Okay, so let's see. Okay. Mario, okay. Mario, give me the answer.
Sweden.
A. Okay, A. So let's check. A. Let's see. All of you are agree? Okay.
No.
No. Okay, Carlos Cornejo, what is the option?
Switzerland.
Okay, B. You say that is B. Okay, let me see here in the chat. Ivania says that is C. Okay, all of you have different options, yeah? Okay, so let's see. Ah, let me see here in the chat. Okay, Herson says that is B.
It's Switzerland. Okay.
Let's see. One, two, let's count 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. So B. Let me check if it is B. It's not B, it's Switzerland.
It's Switzerland.
Okay, is C, Switzerland. Okay, let's start one more time.
¿Quién viene de un país que se llama Switzerland?
Okay, agree. Okay. Okay, let's continue. Turn up your microphone. Okay, agree comes from, so which is this one? Greece. Yeah, we have already done.
Germany.
Okay, next one. Hans comes from Germany and he is German. Yes?
German. German. German.
Everybody choose. Okay, let's see. Teresa is from Spain and she is Spanish. Yes?
Okay. Spanish.
Next one. Let's see. Roberto comes from Portugal and he is Portuguese.
Portuguese.
Okay. Next one. Let's see. A Swedish is from
Switzerland. Switzerland.
Okay. And the last one. Let's see. 1 million. A Dutch comes from. Listen, okay, listen. Okay, write in the chat your answer. A, B, C, or D. The majority of the letter wins. Okay, los que escriban la mayor letra, esos ganan. Okay, write in the chat your answer. Okay. So let's see. Okay, excellent. Let me check. Okay, the majority of you says that is the letter C. Okay. So, it's the winner. Let me choose the first letter C. Deutschland. Okay, in that case, it's Holland. Okay, Holland.
No.
Okay, so we don't win. Okay, we don't are millionaire. Okay,
or
we
are not millionaire today.
Okay, so let's see.
Then we study.
Yes, okay. So let's see. Let's continue. Don't forget this one, yeah? If you are Dutch, okay, that's mean you come from Holland, yeah? Okay, that's good. Now, we check this part, yeah? Okay, this one is about will, okay? Remember, this one is another topic that I evaluate in the test. Okay, remember will we use when actions that you develop in the future, yeah? That's mean at the moment that you speak, for example. Okay, tomorrow I will travel to Europe, okay? Estoy hablando en este momento, estoy diciendo que voy a viajar, ¿ok? A Europa, es algo futuro, pero lo digo en este momento. Ok, let's see, tomorrow I will eat pollo campero, yes? Ok, this one is an option, ok? That's mean, could be possible, could not, ok? Puede ser posible o no, yes? Ok, so remember, will, you use this expression when you need to say something that happens in the future, okay? That's mean plans that you have. For example, okay, Mario, what are your plans for, let me see, Saturday?
I go to...
Yo iría. Okay, remember this one is a plans that you have in the future, so it is necessary that you use will. Yeah, I will go. Okay, so let me check. Let's see. Ricardo Gamero, what is your plan? Okay, maybe at the end of the year. Okay. ¿Cuáles son sus planes para final de año?
¿Ah?
¿Cuáles son sus planes para final de año?
My plan is sleeping.
Okay, I will sleep. Okay, when the class is finished.
The classes classes will finish.
Okay, excellent. Ivania says, I will go to sleep. Yeah, okay, so maybe you develop the same activity of Ricardo. Yeah, okay, that's good. So let's see, Adriana, let me see, what are your plans? Let me see, in 1 month.
I will go to paint class.
Okay, I will go to take classes. Okay, at a school, yes, excellent. Okay, Carlos Cornejo, tell me, one of your plan.
Ah, una, yo quería decir dos.
Okay, tell me two.
Okay. I will go to the beach.
Okay.
And I will go to chess classes.
Oh, okay, you will go to chess classes. That's good. Okay, so let's see. Now, we try to put in order these words, okay, these connect expressions or sentences in future. Yeah, some of them are questions and the other one are declarative or affirmative sentences, yes? Okay, the first one, go out with you tonight. What do you think is the correct order in that case?
Will you go out tonight?
Okay, excellent. Remember, if you have a question with will, so first one, you use the auxiliary, yeah? That means you say, will you, then we have the pronoun or the subject, okay? Go out. Okay, out. Okay, tonight, yes? And at the end, a question mark. Will go out? Will you go out tonight? Yeah. Okay, number two, Ben, tomorrow, go dancing, will. What is the best order?
Ben will tomorrow, no, Ben tomorrow will go dancing.
Okay, but if we use the auxiliary, what is the first word that
will
we use?
Ben, will Ben go dancing tomorrow?
Exactly, okay, will Ben, okay, go dancing tomorrow, okay. When we use a future expression, okay, so we have this time expression, tomorrow, next month, next year, etc. Yes? Okay, this one is a declarative sentence. In June, get married, they will. What is the correct order?
In June, we'll get married.
Ah, okay. First one, identify the subject. What is the subject in the sentence?
They.
Ah, okay, so we write they, then we use the auxiliary in future, that is?
Will.
Okay, will, and then the verb, that is?
Get married.
Okay. Ah, okay, get married in June, exactly. So the time expression is at the end of the sentence. La expresión de tiempo la ponemos al final, yeah? Okay, they will get married in June. Next one, this one is a negative sentence, okay? Next week, won't it be cold? Okay, first one, identify the subject.
Won't it be cold next week.
Okay, what is the negative expression?
Won't.
Okay, won't, exactly. It won't be cold. Okay, next. Exactly, next week. This one is another time expression in future, next week. Okay, number five. By car, she travel will.
Will she travel by car?
Okay. Yes, this one is the correct order. Okay, number six. Let's see. Live on the Mars, want people.
People want to live on the Mars.
Okay, people.
Want live on the Mars.
Okay, want live on the Mars. Yes. Okay, excellent. Number seven. Gary Moo will to New York.
Gary will move to New York.
Exactly. Okay, to New York. At the end, we check, yeah, if the sentence is correct. Let's see, number eight. London to go, Joe will win.
Joe will go to London when?
Okay, listen. First one.
When?
Ah, okay, the WH word or the WH question. When
Joe Will Joe?
Ajá.
Go to London.
Okay, go to London. Yes. Okay, so we have, when will Joe go to London? Yes, okay. So let's see. Let me check. Okay, so we finish. So we check the answers. Okay, let me move in that bar. Yes, all of this going out okay. 10 from 10. Yes? Okay.
Nos sacamos un 10 en el examen.
Ah, yeah. Okay, so remember.
Como la mina estaba ayudando.
Okay, but listen. Okay, don't forget this one. When you have a question with will, first one, you write the auxiliary in future. In that case, it's will. Yes? Then you identify what is the subject. You write the subject. Then the verb. And at least, okay, you are at the end of the sentence, you write the time expression in future, yes? Maybe if you have a declarative sentence, okay, first one is the subject, then the auxiliary in future, that is will, then the verb, and at the end, the time expression. And if this one is in negative, similar to the sentence number four, okay, first one is the subject, then the negative expression in future, that in this case is won't, okay, then the verb, and then the complement of the time expression in future, yeah? Okay, don't forget this part. This one is important, okay? Because it is necessary that you check the order, okay? That's good. Okay, let me check if we have another exercise here. Yes, we have a lot of, yeah? Okay, let me see one that is easy. Let me check this one. Okay, let me move if it is possible. Yes. Okay, so let's see, what will you do tomorrow? If we have different actions here, yeah? Okay, eat a sandwich, take a shower, clean my home, drink a coffee, play soccer, work at home, go to the gym, and stay at home. So we look at the images or the pictures and complete the sentence. And we use will. For example, number one, I, if we pass in future.
I ate.
Okay, listen. This one is in future. Remember the structure.
I will eat a sandwich.
Okay, I will eat a sandwich. Exactly. Okay, this one is number one. Number two, let's do orally, yeah? Okay. Let me check.
She will take a shower.
Okay, she will take a shower. Okay, don't forget the will. She will take a shower. Number three, clean my home. I will clean my home. Exactly. Okay, don't forget the auxiliary will. Next one, drink a coffee.
I will drink a coffee.
Okay, I will drink a coffee. Play soccer.
I will play soccer.
Yes, work at home.
I will work at home.
Okay, I will work at home. Go to the gym.
I will go to the gym.
Okay, I will go to the gym. And the last one, stay at home.
I will stay home.
Okay, I will stay home. Okay, excellent. So let's see. Imagine that the sentences are negative. Okay, for example, play soccer. I won't play soccer. Okay, this one is the contracted form. Or maybe you can say, I will not play soccer. Yes, in both are okay. And ambas son correctas. Contractada, no contractada. Yes. I won't play soccer. I will not play soccer. Yes. I won't eat a sandwich. I will not eat a sandwich. I won't work at home. I won't go to the gym. I won't stay home. Yes. Okay. This one is in negative. Okay. So let's see, if this one is a question, maybe I say, will you play soccer? Will you eat a sandwich? Will she take a shower? Will she go to the gym? Yeah, if this one is a question. Okay, don't forget the auxiliary. I don't know if you have a question about the topics that we studied today. No?
No,
mi adiós.
Claro. No.
Miss, yo tengo una pregunta.
Ok, dígame, Gerson.
El dinero era real o era de mentira.
Ok, if the money was real, ok, that's good. No, it's not real. Ok, bye bye. Ok, bye.
¿Puedo contarle algo?